Good morning, children. Last class we concluded with one boy. That boy aged 4 years old. This boy, he came from the school. In his pocket one letter is there. His teacher wrote a letter. In that letter, it gave the message to the mother that your Tommy is too stupid to learn. The reason is there for the Tommy. Tommy is a partially deaf boy. He can't listen properly. Maybe because of that reason he is a little bit backward student. But mothers are the first to teach about every person there in their life. Because of that, we want to hats up our mothers. We want to respect our mothers. And we want to be always helpful to our mothers. Here the mother, she wrote a letter. Reply to the teacher. Dear teacher, my Tommy is not stupid. I can teach myself. She is a mother that she proved her child to the world. And here the boy not went to, he had only a few years of formal education. But he invented 10,000 inventions. More than 10,000 inventions. He is none other than Thomas Alva Edison. Thomas Alva Edison, he went for the school only few years. He not educated highly. But his inventions are very useful to the world. See, teacher, she is not interested to teach him. But he became as a great one. Shall we say this all the people are failures? No, we can't say. See, if we learn something from our failure, then only we can get the success. If we not learn from our failure, then we can't get our success. Here few of the words they gave us that, I will say them. One thing is that successful people don't do great things, they only do small things in great way. Most of the successful people are there. Generally what we will feel, if any small thing if we invent, then we will say our neighbor there, here. We will try to expose it out. Means hide it is, it's myself. Even if you observe that your parents, if you draw a small picture very neatly, then that picture, nowadays they will post in the WhatsApp groups. Oh see, my child, he did there. Actually that was the intention of that parent, and he liked that and he want to encourage you, and he impressed that much and he want to encourage you that much. But some of the time others as we also will post that, oh I did this, but we did a small thing. We will try to expose it lot. These great people, they never do big things. They will do small things. But they won't expose. But in a great way, they will do that. We will do small things in a great way, but they will do great things in a small way. Because they will hide that. They won't expose out. Okay, here, one more person is there. His name is Ford. Now, Ford cars are the world famous cars. Ford, when he found that car, at the time he forgot to keep the reverse gear. But now, the same car, it's a world famous car it is now. See, we can't say he is a failure. Thomas Edison, at the age of 67, one day, his total laboratory burnt into ashes. He said one great thing, disasters, they gave one of the choice to us. That is a great disaster. His disciple, one of the disciples, he said that, sir, everything we lost. Then he said, disasters, they are giving a lot of opportunity to us. In that term, burning my all the mistakes which I committed up to now, all are burning. Let it be. I will try again newly. I will overcome all the mistakes. Then, within the weeks, after burning some $1 million of property, he overcame that. Within the weeks, he invented phonograph. That the spirit this Thomas Alva Edison he had. And some more words are there here for you. See, all success stories are stories of great failure. The only difference is that every time they failed, they bounced back. It's a fact that if one small failure comes to us, we will feel, said now, in unit test, simply 1 or 2 marks, if you get less, then a feeling that, oh, I lost the mark. Actually, your parents, please understand the problem of the child that we are not supposed to force them why the mark is less. But we want to encourage at the same time that next time the mark should be improved. Here, at that 1 mark or 2 mark, it's not the failure of us. Why we lost the mark there? That was important. By that, we want to learn. Next time, this 1 or 2 mark, I don't want to lose. And how to overcome that? If we do that, then the success will come to us. This is called rather than falling forward rather than backward. Oh, I lost 2 marks, my work completed, my life completed, then you are the failure. Why I got 2 marks less? Where I made the mistake? I researched and I lost my teacher. I will get a clarification. Why they deducted the 2 marks to me? I want the reason. Then after the clarification, if we follow the instructions which are given by the teacher, then we will get the success. Be careful. Here below are some more examples, the failures of successful people. Thomas Edison, you know that 10,000 times he failed to invent the bulb. That all we know. Next, Henry Ford, he broke out in a car accident at the age of 40. He met with a car accident. He founded that Ford car and he died in the car accident itself. 42, he fired Lee Iacocca. Lee Iacocca was a great businessman. He was fired by this Ford too. And for Beethoven, he was a musician, music player, great music player. Like Disney, he also actually insulted a lot of times. So many of them, they said he has no talent. But after that, who said he has no talent? They praised him and he became world famous musician. And setbacks are inevitable in life. A setback can act driving force and also teach us humility. Setbacks are there in our life. We should want to have setback. Otherwise, we won't get the success. And they will teach us the moral values also. Whenever we will fail, some of the moral value we can learn from that. See, one more thing he said that in grief, you will find courage and faith to overcome the setback. Whenever the problem will come. If you have the dareness, not for all the people it is possible. Who have the strong mind, who have the positive thinking, that all the people, they will face that problem with the dareness. So at the time, our mind will become very strong. That is important. We need to learn to become victors, not victims. As the victors, we want to live in this life, not as the failures. I never should be a failure. That should be there in your mind. See, fear and doubt short circuit the mind. Two things are very important. We want to avoid them. Fear, doubt. If any doubt about ourselves, doubt means not the doubt of subject that I need this. First of all, we want to have the confidence on this. Not the overconfidence, but confidence should be need. I can do. But not only I can. It's wrong. I can. That's enough. Not myself only. It's wrong. But I want to be have such idea that I can do. Not a big problem to me. If I try, minimum if I try, maybe I can solve. That want to be there in our mind. So it's important. See, the motivation to success comes from the burning desire to achieve a purpose. If you have a burning desire, then only we can achieve the success. Even story is there for that, I will say. Napoleon Hill said that whatever the mind of man can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve. Conceive means plan. Whatever our mind can plan that and our mind can believe, that the things we will achieve. If our mind it won't plan anything, if our mind it won't believe anything, then we can't achieve. Here, a small story is there in this lesson that one of the disciples of Socrates, he came to the Socrates and asked him, "Sir, what is the secret of success?" Socrates said, "You come tomorrow morning and we will meet at the river bank." Disciple came to the river bank. Next day morning, both the teacher and the student, they met. And Socrates asked, "Come with me." They are walking into the water. When the water came to their neck level, suddenly Socrates, he hold his head and he ducked him into the water. Socrates waited there until the boy is changing into blue color, means he's going to die within seconds. At that time, he bring out his head and he asked one great question. That the question is that, what do you want most when you are in the water? It's maybe we will feel that he is a fool. Not only we. When the Socrates, he lived on this earth, all the people, they felt, most of the people, they felt that he is a mad fellow. And they beat him with the stones. Even the king, he killed him by giving poison. He kept him into the jail. He asked the questions to avoid the people. But people are the fools. They thought that Socrates is the fool. But these people are the fools. Because he want to aware all the people about the society. They not understood that. When the king, he gave the poison to him, at the time he not fear for anything. While smiling, he drank that. That the greatness he had. So Socrates asked, "What you want when you are in the water most?" The boy replied very clearly, "Sir, I want air." See, that is the secret of success, Socrates said. How the air? Air means I am breathing lot of air every day, then success will come to me. No. The inside the water, there is no air has to breathe. We can't breathe properly. If we stay inside the water sometime, then we will die. If we want to live, we need air. That the person is desire. I want to get air. I want to live. He has a strong desire in his mind that air I want. Whatever may be. I don't want anything. I need only one thing. That is the air. So burning desire, it should need for us. We can, most of the people, we will make some of the target in our mind, but the target always it will change according to our comfort. Some of the age we will fix as an engineer. Another age we will fix as a doctor. Another age we will fix up another profession. Because our desire is not strong. But whichever the desire, whichever the goal we fix at the first time, if we fix for that, then, and if you think about it, and if you work about it, then the success will come to us. So it's need to stick with the one of the goal. Stick with your goal, and not only by sticking, you want to do the hard work, and you want to search the ways how to overcome the difficulties, and how I can go near to that goal. That also important. Here, some more words are there. I will read, just you see in your textbook. If you think you are beauty, then you are, right? I am the loser. First only without any effort. If I think myself, I am the loser, I am the loser itself. Already you lost. No need to attempt again back. That's important. If you think you are outclassed, you are same. If you think you are the loser, you should be the loser. Outclassed, they defeated me. Then you must be defeated. If you think you dare not, you don't. Oh, I can do or not. It is possible to me or not. If you not dare, you never do the dare. You have got to think high to rise. Always you want to think high. High means not in the overconfidence, but the confidence in positive way we want to think. If you like to win, but think you can't. Inside the heart, I want to win, I want to win. But in the mind, maybe or not. May or not. That's the doubt. Then at that time, you can't win. Inside, in the heart, in the mind, must want to win this. You can ever win a prize. If you have the doubt in the mind, if you have the desire in the heart, then you never get the prize. If you think you will lose, you are lost. First, only if you think, I am the loser, what the loser compulsory? Even if you show 100% of effort there, but you are the loser. You won't get any prize. Life's battle don't always go. Life battle, it is not an easy work. We want to fight with it, with the dareness, with the confidence, with the positive attitude. We want to fight with it. Otherwise, we are the losers. For out in the world, we find to the strong and the faster man. We want to be strong and faster man to the world. Whoever will see to us, they want to think, yes, he is a perfect man, he is a perfect boy, she is a perfect girl, she can do, she is a strong girl, he is a strong boy. That they want to think, that we want to prove to the world. Success begins with a fellow's will, our will only, our success. Whatever will is there, what the desire is there, that only our success. Strong desire, it is a success. But sooner or later, the man who wins, it's all in the state of mind. The person who are winning, he will win only by his mind. That's enough. Is the man who thinks he can. Winner who wins, who will think that? I am the winner. That the winner it should be. Okay? In this lesson, continuation of here some of the exercises are there in the page number 8, 9, 10, 11. So these are the exercises. In that, some of the exercises are connected with the lesson. Up to page number 8, 9, 10 are connected with the lesson. You have to read the lesson and you want to do that exercises. One more grammar point is there, that is defining, non-defining, relative clause. I will explain simply to you defining, non-defining, relative clause in the next class. Okay, next class, before starting of that, I will explain about each and I will give some of the notes. Up to that, whichever the remaining homework is there that you have to do. You want to write the summaries in your notes and you want to write the exercises in your notes. And main and first thing that you have to read the textbook. Read a textbook and think about your life, your goal, and be positive. Stay home, stay safe.